So Golgi body is also known as Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus. The scientist who discovered Golgi body was Camillo Golgi, and after his name, the name of the organism so that is given Golgi body or Golgi complex. The number and the shape and the size is variable because the number of the Golgi body so that is different in different cell, and mainly the Golgi apparatus that is found in secretory cell. The number is more in secretory cell and it is less in non-secretory cell. If any cell is secreting anything, any material, like for example, suppose you take pancreas. Pancreas secreting different type of enzymes. For example, liver, it is secreting bile. So the number is more in secretory cell in comparison to the non-secreting cell. And the size is also variable depending on the activity of the cell. And the shape is also variable. You can find out there are different shapes of the Golgi apparatus are there. Either it is tube-like, or it is big vessel-like, or it is small vacuum-like. So there are different shapes of the Golgi apparatus. Now in animal cell it is found near the nucleus. Generally in the animal cell the Golgi apparatus that is found near the nucleus. Okay? Whereas in the plant cell you can find out it is scattered in the cytoplasm. Why? Because mainly in the vertebrates, in the animal cell, there is only one Golgi apparatus, and the apparatus that is situated near the nuclear membrane. Whereas in the invertebrate and the plant cell, because the number is many, it is around 16 to 20 numbers are there, so they are found scattered in the cytoplasm. And there are three shapes are there. One is cisternae, second is the vacuole, third is the vesicle. Cisternae, so that is tube-like. Just like tubes, and the end of the tubes are solar. Okay, but this tube is not straight tube. In place of the straight tube, you can find out they are little bit rounded like this, and the tip is solar. So this is called cisternae. So the Golgi body does not look like this. It looks like this. And the vacuole, these are all big vacuoles are there. Okay? And the vesicle means small vacuole. So the shape of the Golgi body or the Golgi apparatus, so that is also variable. And the number is also variable. Either you can find out it is one in number or it is many in number. And again in the cisternae, generally there is not one single cisternae. You can find out there are many are there. So like this there are many cisternae are there and also they are connected to each other. So you can find out there is connectivity is there in between two cisternae. So that any material which need to be secreted, they can be transferred from one cisternae to another cisternae. So the cisternae is having two phase. One is called transphase and another is called cis. So this is the concave side of the Golgi body and this is the convex side. So the concave side that is facing towards the cell membrane. Whereas the convex side, so that is facing towards the nuclear membrane. And this transphase that is also known as maturing phase. And the cis side that is also known as formation phase. Alright, so always you can find out the convex side, so that is towards the cell membrane, and the convex side that is towards the nuclear membrane. Now we will discuss about function of Golgi body. So Golgi body is really responsible for packaging material to be delivered either into the cell or outside the cell. So what do you understand by the packaging of the material? Packaging of the material means the material will be there inside the vacuum. So that is called packaging. And the material to be packaged in the form of vesicle from endoplasmic reticulum fuse with the cis phase and move towards the maturing phase. Now you see the diagram. This is the nucleus to the nuclear membrane endoplasmic reticulum is connected, and the rough endoplasmic reticulum it is having ribosome on its outer surface, and the ribosome they are synthesizing proteins. So the proteins which are produced by the ribosomes, now these proteins they are moving towards the Golgi apparatus, because I told you the Golgi apparatus, so that is present near the nuclear membrane. So this one is called the formation phase. Now the protein will enter inside the Golgi body. Okay, then because all the systems they are connected to each other, then gradually the Golgi, the protein, so that can move from one system into the other system. So while moving, there is the modification is there in the proteins. So what kind of the changes is required? So that changes are taking place inside the Golgi body, and at last the protein, so that will reach to the this swollen portion. Now this swollen portion, now it will increase in size. Then it will separate from Golgi apparatus in the form of the vacuole or vesicle. So that is, now this vacuole is having protein, and inside the vacuole the hydrolytic enzymes are there. So these hydrolytic enzymes, they can break the proteins and they can produce the other material, or they can produce the energy. Okay, so these are all the function of Golgi bodies, and also it is also synthesizing glycoprotein and the glycolipids. When the protein is connected to carbohydrate or the lipid is connected to carbohydrate, then that is called glycoprotein or glycolipid. So the Golgi apparatus, that is the site where the protein can combine with carbohydrate, or the lipid can also combine or the join with the carbohydrate. So they are also synthesizing the glycolipid and glycoprotein. The next organelle, that is nucleus. Nucleus is a very important organelle in any living cell. If there is no nucleus, then the cell cannot be said as living. So the nucleus, that is also called as controlling center of the cell, because it is responsible to control all activities of the cell. Nucleus was discovered by Robert Brown in the year 1831, and the name chromatin was given by Fleming, because we can dye or color chromosomes. There are different dyes are there, colors are there, acidic dye and the basic dye. By the coloring, the chromatin, so that was discovered by Fleming, and the name was also given by Fleming. So what are the properties of nucleus? Generally one cell is having one nucleus, and mainly the nucleus, so that is located in the center of the cell. Interphase nucleus has chromatin. While explaining the chapter cell division, I had told you before, actually the cell divides, there is another phase, resting phase. So that phase is called interphase. So in the interphase, if you make a slide of any cell patch and you see under the microscope, then the chromosomes are not visible. You can see highly coiled thread-like structure, and these are called chromatin. So in the interphase, inside the nucleus in place of chromosomes, we can see chromatin. Then perinuclear space is present. Nucleus is having double membrane. This is the outer membrane and this is the inner membrane. And there is a space in between the outer and the inner membrane, that is called perinuclear space. Also small openings are there. The place where the openings are there, these two membranes are joined together. So there is a small pore is there, and with the help of the pore, there is exchange of material between the cytoplasm and the nucleoplasm. Then inside the nuclear membrane, the fluid portion. And inside the cell, cytoplasm is there, which is the fluid portion. Similarly, here the fluid portion, so that is called nucleoplasm. So inside the nucleoplasm, you can see either chromatin or the chromosomes are there. And also there is another spherical feature is present, which is called nucleolus. So you have to remember the spelling of nucleus and the nucleolus, because many times children, they get confused. Okay. So what is the function of the nucleolus? So the function is RNA synthesis, ribosomal RNA synthesis. You know what is the difference between DNA and the RNA. DNA is making chromosomes, and the DNA can produce the RNA. There are three types of RNA: messenger RNA, transfer RNA, and ribosomal RNA. So the nucleus, that is making ribosomal RNA. So inside nucleus, chromosomes are there. For example, suppose you are taking one human cell, then there are 46 chromosomes are there. So all different species, they are having their own constant chromosome number. For example, P is having 16 chromosome number. If you see the chromosome number in dog and the cat, these are all the variable numbers. Okay? Even if the number is also same, then the number of genes and the character of the gene and the position of genes, so that will be variable. So each and every living organism, any particular species, they are having a constant chromosome number. So chromosome is made up of DNA and histone. If you see chromosome under the microscope, then you can see that there are two arms of chromosome. This is one arm and this is another arm. So these are called the arms. And the point where the two arms are connected, so that point is called centromere. Okay? So what is the chemical composition of chromosome? Chromosome is made up of DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. And the protein which is associated with DNA, the name of the protein is histone protein. In some of the organisms, besides the histone protein also, there are some non-histone protein, they are also present. Then what is kinetochore? On the side of the centromere, there is another, you can find out there is another knob-like structure is present. So that is called kinetochore. So the centromere, so that is the point where the two arms they will meet. And on the side, there is a disc-like structure which is called kinetochore. Depending on the position of centromere, we are classifying chromosomes into four types: metacentric, submetacentric, acrocentric, and telocentric. So in the metacentric, just in the middle part, centromere, so that is located just in the middle, so that the size of arms on the both sides of centromere, so that is equal. So this kind of chromosome is called metacentric. In submetacentric, the centromere is little away from the center. So one arm is a little bit shorter and the other is longer. Then the acrocentric, one arm, so that is very tall, long, and the other is short. So this is called acrocentric. And in the telocentric, one arm is missing. So the diagram which is given in your book, so that is the wrong diagram, because the arms are shown there. But actually in the telocentric, the centromere, so that is at the tip or at the end. So one arm is missing and there is another arm. So this kind of the chromosome, that is called telocentric. So what is the function of nucleus? The nucleus, that is called controlling center of the cell, and it is controlling rest of the cell organelles which are present in the cell or in the cytoplasm.